Welcome to this quick instructional video on the menus and features in the Protimeter MMS2. To turn it on, we use this center button here. To navigate, all you need to do is know that it goes up, down, to the right, and this button here is backwards. So we'll get to our main menu here where you can select the function. So the first function we'll select is pin moisture measurement. So scroll to pin moisture measurement, then press the enter button. Here you'll see our moisture content here. And when I put my fingers across the pins to get a reading, you can see the green, yellow, and red bar at the bottom together with the moisture level. By pushing down, you can actually choose different wood species should you need to. If you go into the pin mode and press the right hand button for 2 seconds, you can get a reference value. So that means you can take a dry standard. So let's take a measurement here and we'll call our dry standard here at 16.5%, hold the right hand button. And now on the top display, you'll see the actual reading. And on the lower display, you'll see whether you're above or below that dry standard you stored by pushing the right hand button. Of course, in the MMS2, the accessories that plug into the side here work in exactly the same way. If you want to store a reading, you can also do that from any of these functions for its internal memory. Now let's look at the pinless moisture measurement mode, also called non-invasive. So we push the arrow down once, press enter. Now we're in the pinless mode here. This is giving us readings from the back. Again, you can see the green, yellow, and red, as well as the reference reading there. It also, just like on the pin mode, says wet, at risk, and dry. You can also use the reference mode that we showed you on the pin mode here by pushing this button for 2 seconds once you've found your dry standard material you want to use as a reference. Okay, so let's go back to the main menu by pushing backwards here, and we'll go to our hygrometer mode. Now there's a humidity sensor on the back of this instrument here, and it's displaying our relative humidity and temperature in degrees Fahrenheit. Also at the bottom here, it's important to note the serial number of the quick stick. The MMS2 will take a variety of different sensors from us, including our hygrostick and extended quick stick. Okay, and now we go back to the main menu and go down to our psychometric mode. Here, you'll see a secondary menu, and you can choose whichever psychometric measurement you want. So let's choose dew point in this case. So here we can see the dew point displayed in the large number here, but also it displays relative humidity and temperature below as well. Again, you have the serial number of the sensor used. This is dew point. Let's look at grains per pound as we're in degrees Fahrenheit. And you can see the grains per pound here expressed as mixing ratio, the relative humidity and temperature all on the same screen. And it's the same for enthalpy and vapor pressure. Next down here, we can go to our surface temperature probe. So in the side of the instrument here is a secondary port. There's an optional surface temperature probe to give you highly accurate surface temperature readings, often used in coatings applications. But also this button here is our IRT button. And if you press this once, you will take surface infrared measurements. So you can point this at a wall, take a temperature measurement. If you press it twice, it'll give you the laser. So let's just do that as a demonstration. We need to remove this cap here in order to allow the emitter to come out of here. And press this once and twice for the laser. So you would see the laser on the wall here. And on the top here, it's showing the actual temperature and then our differential to dew point. Here it's saying no condensation. You can demonstrate this quite easily by getting a cold drink can out of a refrigerator and pointing it at it. You'll see the condensation will start to form and the lower bar here will turn to red and indicate that there's condensation. This function is really useful because often you want to know whether there's condensation occurring or you're close to condensation causing that moisture issue. Okay, going back to the main menu here, we can go and quickly look at our settings. In the settings here, we can set our units from metric to non-metric, and you just move up and down here and press the enter button to save. So we'll move it to metric here, press enter, go backwards, and now we'll be in metric. We can set our date and time here. The date and time appears at the top right hand part of the display here. Now this can also be set in your computer software. The software can be downloaded free from our website, and every MMS2 comes with the cable, the USB cable, to plug into your computer. And so if you want to do data logging, you need to set the date and time, and this can either be done directly in the instrument here or easily within the software. The next setting function is auto off. So this shows you how many minutes you can leave the meter to stay on after you've pressed the last button. So in this case, we've left it to 6, and we'll press enter to save that. Back to the main menu again, and we'll set our brightness. Now the brightness is set at 10, and if we want to change that, we can go and use the arrow buttons to the appropriate setting. If you leave it at 10, you will use the battery up quicker than use it at 5. So set it to what's appropriate, and that will maximize the battery time. We'll set ours to 5 here, hit enter, it's now at 5. We can also turn the buzzer on and off here in the same fashion. And here is a factory function called calibration. This is only available to the factory. We can also set our logging function within the instrument as well as on the software. So if you want to log relative humidity and temperature, you can set up when you want to start it. So you could start it, I only want to start it in an hour's time. You can log the interval, so how often the readings are taken. You can say, okay, I want to stop after 3 hours, take no more readings. And then you can allocate a job number. So if you want to save that data for a particular site, you can choose an individual number here. And go back to the main menu. And there we are. Thank you very much for watching this quick instructional video on how to use the MMS2.